Okay, and then we go put our wheel back on. Put our car back on. It was so easy to install, I think I'm just gonna try to install it. Alright, so what you're gonna wanna do here. So now it's gonna be a little harder, I'm not gonna lie. what you're gonna wanna do is push your rim lock out and then put the tire in between the rim lock and the rim. And then go ahead and try to install your this like that, okay. And then try to get the bottom in first. Geez, this tire is so soft. Jeezers. It's no wonder this thing is spinning. Right? Wow, okay. It's like installing a bicycle tire. I didn't expect it to be that easy. Okay, so the rim lock's in there already. Now what we're going to want to do is put our tube in, and we're going to use our new tube, this double tough stuff here. We can compare it to the stock CST tube also. So there you go. This is for a 2.753 inch rim, and I think it's 2.75 is what this is. Oh, okay, this one uses a two. The stock tube is a two and a quarter. So it's actually this tube is actually a little bigger than this one. So, but that's okay. If that's what they use in the, I'll just have to remember to get a smaller one next time. I don't think I could find one that's smaller than that, dude. All right. So as you can see, it's much thicker than the other one. Much thicker. It should be fine though. Go ahead and take all this goodies off. Take one of the nuts off. Okay. Set that aside. Now what you're going to want to do is, I don't know how hard this is going to be, kind of line up where your valve stem is supposed to go inside there. What you can do is get some baby powder so we keep from pinching the, I should have probably put some inside the, I'm gonna put some baby powder on the tube so it makes it a little slippery so you don't pinch the tube so easily. All dirt bike stuff Hades Omega's learned, you know. I learned this from dirt bikes. And this lets it slip around in there a little more easily. Okay. That's good. Kind of makes a mess. You probably have to clean your wheel up a little bit. Alright, so I got the valve stem oriented properly. What we're going to do next is we're going to remove the new valve stem core. There's some air in there too. Okay, and then I'm gonna attempt to put it in without the tool, but
so make sure your rim strip hole is lined up before you freaking put the tire back on. Let me see if I can.
Okay, it's only a little bit off. So I'm gonna just kind of shift that to the side a bit. Okay, I've got the holes kind of lined up. Okay, it's the rim is a bit kind of small and it's hard to contort, so. I got the tool, might as well use it. Okay, so this is what you call a valve fishing tool right here. It's basically a handle with the wire cable on it and then the part that screws onto your valve stem. So what you're gonna do is What I'm going to do is put the tool in first through the hole, the other way. Fish it in there. Okay. Pull it out the other end. Okay. Then we're going to connect it to the valve stem. Screw it together. Okay. And then try to get it in there. Pull it out. It should go through the hole. And it does. There we go. So when you have the right tools, it makes the job much easier. Okay, so now go ahead and stuff the rest of your tube in there. I'm sure if I struggled with it more, I could have got it in there. It's okay. So what that does is makes the tube more slippery, and so you can so you might not pinch the tube. I'm gonna just feed the tube into the rim. Make sure you get it over the rim lock. Over the rim lock. Okay. It's over the rim lock now. There. Okay. Okay, so what you're going to want to do next is take the Fisher tool out. Make sure the valve stem is straight too. It's pretty straight. If it's not straight, try to rotate the wheel, the tire a little bit. Okay. And then, so you don't lose it in there, put the nut back in. But don't screw it in all the way. Just screw it like halfway. Okay. All right, and then we go. We just go install it. So it helps if you put a little bit of air in the tube. That keeps you from pinching the tube. You don't want to pinch the tube. You'll have to repair it or buy a new one, and that's no fun. I'm going to go ahead and put the valve core back in. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and put a little bit of air in the tube. Put this guy on. This is why you probably want to put that in there, so you can put air in it. I'm going to move this to where the little rim lock cutout is. Put a little bit of air in there. Just a little bit, not a lot. Maybe a little more than that. Okay. Okay, that seems like good. All right, so what you're going to want to do is start opposite of the rim lock. Maybe we can put this in by hand. Let's start at the valve stem right here. Okay. Push that in. Push it in. Okay, it's not working. I have to use a tool to do it. So we're gonna go get a spoon. Yeah, we'll just spoon it on. We didn't have to use the spoons before, but try not to pinch the tube, but that's why we put air in it, right? See if we can do this without any kind of lube. So one thing I do like about these Shinko Trials tires is they're really soft and they're really easy to install. Look at that. So easy. Trust me, the big motorcycle wheels are much difficult. Much more difficult to install. I'm taking big bites here too. No beat buddy, nothing. Okay. It's gonna get harder if you don't drop it into the bead, though. Okay. Then we'll start walking it. And what you're gonna want to do, what you're gonna want to do when you get close, I think we may have to take three more bites. But when you get to the final part where you have to, when you have to get it into the rim lock, what you're gonna have to do is push the rim lock up, push it up like this, and then work it in, and then that makes sure that the rim lock is on top of the bead. Said three more bites, I think. This is number two right here. Oh no, maybe we can do one more bite. Okay, so push up on this. Hopefully you're not pinching the tube or anywhere. Looks okay. Okay, and then all I have to do is push it home. There we go. Okay, did it by itself. Make sure you push that all the way out and get it in there. Okay. All right, that's it. Tire's on there. Now what we're gonna do is seat the bead. Let's go put air in it. What you want to do, also what you want to do before you inflate it, is make sure you this weight, man, it's in the way. Make sure there's no tube that's getting pinched between the tire and the rim, because that will make it flat. Get a pinch rod. Well, it looks like we're okay. Yeah, we're good. Okay. So go ahead and inflate it. Okay, it's trying to seat itself. Probably put like 40 psi. Okay. Looks like it's good. So it's seated fairly nicely. We'll flip it over, make sure it's seated. Looks good. Oh, just to make. So what I like to do is inflate and deflate the tube like four times. So it makes sure like this the tube is properly seated inside the tire. So how I'm gonna do that is we're gonna take the valve stem out. We're gonna inflate it and deflate it four times to like, I don't know, like 40 psi. That's cool. Okay. You can see the valve stem start trying to stick out too when you inflate it. Go put the valve stem back in. And now I'm going to inflate it to 15 psi. Okay, so my battery ran out and the camera battery ran out. And it like didn't record that last video. So the last video was of me installing the tire, installing the wheel back onto the bike. That's not so hard, pretty much the opposite. I was just gonna talk you through it. I'm not gonna go through it again. So basically you're gonna wanna put your spacers back on. Remember I had the left spacer here and the right spacer on the other foot peg. I stuck them back in and then I put the wheel on. I rolled the wheel on, and then you put the caliper onto the rotor right there. Like make sure the rotor is between the two pads, and then you're gonna have to make sure you
there's a little, there's like an indentation for the, or like a cavity for the spacer to go into on the bracket. Make sure you put that in there first and then slide it onto the swing arm. And then try to get both sides on. It got kind of hung up on the right side, so I pulled it out a little bit and it dropped. And then you just put the axle back in with the adjuster on there. Actually, don't put the adjuster in yet. And then push the wheel all the way in, and then walk your chain back on. And then put the, push the axle all the way through to the other side. And then make sure the... and then put your adjuster blocks on like they are right now. And then make sure your wheel is properly aligned. And then put your put the nut back on and tighten it to 40, like it was like 41 to 44 foot-pounds. I torqued it to 41 foot-pounds is what I did. If you're on the side of the trail and you're doing this, just, you know, just get as tight as you can get it with the tool you're using. yeah. So there it is. So that's it. So I will be I'll be racing this bike in the Coyote Creek Sprint Enduro this weekend. I don't think we're going to do too well because this bike is really slow. Okay. I'm not going to lie. I took it out to practice last weekend or earlier last week. And it was so slow, dude. We weren't doing so good. But I have faith that we will not have a flat tire due to a spun valve stem. So that's good. I highly, highly suggest if you're going to be riding this bike on the trails, you install a rim lock on it. Now it did install kind of crooked. I don't know. It's pretty straight. And it looks all right. I don't know. It is. It's kind of pointing this way a little bit, but I think it'll be okay. Hopefully. I will make a follow-up video after the race, and I'll let you guys know how the bike did. There'll be a follow-up video for the race, and I will talk about the rim lock. We'll check it again. I left it loose. To make sure, so you can check to see if it's moving at all. If it didn't move at all, then we did a good job. That's what you want. You don't want to be sitting on the side of the trail with a flat tire, because you spun the valve stem. That is not the way I want to spend the day. So save yourself some headaches on the trail. And go ahead and do this. Install a rim lock now. You know, it's more of a hassle. It's harder to install and uninstall the tubes and the tires, but it's worth it because you won't get your you won't be stuck on the side of the trail like some poor suckers. and the good thing is we can run really low tire pressures now. We can run like, you know, 12, 10 psi or something. If we wanted to, I'm gonna run 15, but even at just 15, it's already, you know, it's already trying to spin itself, so that's a no-go. The front, I will not put a rim lock on. I don't even have one on the front of this bike right here, and it's fine. It doesn't move at all. So unless you're braking really, really, really hard, and we're not really braking that hard, hopefully. hopefully 15 is not enough to spin it. But I was surprised how easy it was to uninstall and install that tire. That tire is super soft. That's why it's a trials tire. that it's got to be really soft so you can, you know, it grips well on the rocks and stuff, you know. But I found out on the really loose stuff, it's not a really good tire. I found that out this week. This bike has a hard time climbing those hills. Especially, I think it just has too much torque, too. The tires just don't want to... They don't want to hook up, and it just makes it worse, you know. I feel that there's too much sprocket in there, man. That 62 is too big. Maybe like a 50 would be okay, or 50 something would be okay. All right, so yeah, that was my rimlock vlog, and there will be after action review video after the race, so check that one out. Here's my go. But we installed the super rim lock, the trackside super rim lock, and this double tough tube. So now we have an extra tube. So when we go riding on the trails, we just take this with us. You know, it's a much lighter than the double tough one, so it makes it better to carry with you. But I feel like it was a good idea to put a better tube in there, a thicker tube, so you know, you won't have any problems with getting punctures on the trails, because you got a beefier tube. But we still got the stock tube on the front, so you know, that's why we have this. So we got an extra one. All right, Ace, be out.